Today's day 14, and Monica and I have some differences of opinion on how we should deal with this sort of threat that we received yesterday. We got a note that said that if we aren't out by sundown today, that people are going to kill us. They said that we could take a pack with us, and that's about it. At the moment, we really don't know anything. I don't know if it's just one person, that just wants us to leave. I don't know if it's a whole group. That's one of the reasons I'm out here, is I'm going to be doing kind of patrols around the house. Monica's staying in there. She's going to monitor the tripwires that I set and everything. And I'm going to be out here. It'd be good if we had more of us outside, but we don't. We only have the two of us. So I'm going to be out here and just seeing if people are kind of starting to move in, getting ready for something, because supposed to go down tonight. Obviously, the bugs are bad over here. Obviously, Monica just wants to leave, and I don't really agree with that. I guess there's different personalities, but also I think to some degree with Monica it's kind of easy come, easy go. Let's just walk out and make sure that we have our lives, and I get that. Your life is more important than any of your stuff. But at the same time, it took me a long time to put all this stuff together, solar panels and all these great things that are here to make our lives easier during this. I don't really want to walk away from all of those either. I don't want to lose my life trying to defend them, but at the moment, all we know is that a rock was thrown through our window, and it had a threatening message on it. It could be, like I said, a whole group of people. It could just be one person that's trying to scare us out, and then they get this windfall of the entire house. I don't know, but, We're taking it seriously, and I'm doing patrols today. I just have the pistol. Monica has the AR inside, but to have a little extra, I've got a few of these on me, additional in case I get pinned down somewhere. I know that the rifle is going to be a stronger weapon, but here in the woods, the proximity of everything is so close. People can't really fire at you from really far away because there's so many trees. I think that there's a fair parity between a rifle and a pistol here because, you're going to have to be kind of close range anyway. But, I guess a hunter scope would be beneficial. Maybe I should pull out the bolt action rifles, but those only hold 3 rounds in them. So it's not really like a fighting weapon, it seems to me. Although maybe I should throw that on. So anyway, yeah, I'm doing patrols around here today. Monica's monitoring the house, and I don't know what our end game is on this. I mean, are we just gonna fight whoever is threatening us if they come in? I don't know. I'm not sure. But at the moment, doing rounds, seeing if we can get a better sense of what the threat really is. Oh my, look at this. All these violets, all food. They're pretty good too. I might collect up a bunch of this stuff. This is, good nutrition to put in with all the things we prepare back at home. Can eat the flowers, the stems, the leaves, everything. Good stuff. I've been around patrolling all day today, and I haven't seen anything. I've been doing larger and larger circles, and I can't see. It doesn't seem like there's anybody setting up in the area, getting ready for anything. But they said sundown tonight is the time. So the plan is Monica's in the house. She's watching the trip sensors. She's gonna defend from there. I'm out here, kind of far away from the house, but with a good view on it. So if anybody does try to, attack our place, I can kind of sneak up behind them, maybe surprise them, and get rid of them that way. So that's the plan. But it involves both Monica and I both staying up all night without sleeping, because we're both in two different places. So that's going to make it difficult. But you got to do what you got to do. Should be happening pretty soon. They said sundown, so I don't know. One thing I am glad that I brought out with me, I always keep it in my EDC, is a bug net for my head, because there's a lot of bugs out here, and not only is this going to make it a lot more comfortable, but I'll also be able to be a lot quieter because I won't be swatting at anything. So I'm really glad I got this little thing. I don't know if I'm hoping they're going to do this thing sooner rather than later. I'm just going to get more and more tired as the night goes on. At the same time, I'm not really looking forward to it. The sun's rising right now, and I don't want to say that last night was a waste of time, but absolutely nothing happened. I didn't hear anybody even approach the house. I don't know what the deal was, but I'm just really tired. I'm heading back to the house now, and I guess I'll check in with Monica and then maybe just relax a little bit and figure out what the next step is.
Hey.
Go ahead.
I just got a hold of someone on the radio.
Oh, another one?
Yeah, it's someone new. It's a group that set up a hospital in Greenville.
Oh, that's not too far from here.
No.
How are they doing?
Great. They have lots of supplies. There's a big group of them.
Well, that's good. It's
pretty
good for them.
Safe. Yeah, they said they have lots of food, too, and I don't know. Would it be worth checking out? It seems like it could be a good option.
You mean for us to go?
Yeah, they've said they could have a couple, more helpful people around, and we're kind of helpful.
Did they actually asked us to come?
Yeah, they invited us. They said it was fine.
It seems like it feels like a too good to be true kind of thing. I mean, especially just the other day, we got like a rock thrown through the window, and they're like, get out of there, and then conveniently, the next day after we don't leave, we get a radio call, and it's like, hey, why don't you guys just leave your place? And I mean, it could be a trek.
We are sitting ducks here, though, aren't we?
Well, wouldn't we be anywhere?
Yeah, but isn't it worth just trying to go out there and figure something else out?
Well, yeah, but if we go out there, we leave the house completely open. What if we go there, it's just a bunch of BS, or there's nothing there, and then we come back here and the house has been ransacked and...
But what if we just stay here for a few more days and all of our supplies run out?
Well, we got a few more supplies and for a few days.
Well, I don't know. We're barely making it as it is, taking shifts, just the two of us.
I guess. But, exhausting. There's just no guarantee there's anything there is the thing. I know it doesn't feel like we have much here, but we've got lots of food, and with two people, we kind of got it going with the sleep cycle and
but
everything.
But are we
going
to be able to last?
I don't know, what was the point of accumulating all this stuff if we're just going to walk away from it at the first little stone through the window? My feeling, nothing happened last night even. They throw the rock through, they're like, it's sundown, they give us a deadline, right? And they don't show up. If they were so able to get us out of here, why would they have even warned us? Why wouldn't they just surprise us, and...
We don't know that they're the same people.
We don't know they're the same people, but... Still, the idea is we're running away from something, and I don't think that these people are necessarily, or just a person, anything to really be worried about. I don't think they would have warned us that they could actually get rid of us. And last night kind of demonstrates it. Nothing happened.
Yet.
What, they didn't set their watches? It was sundown. That's my feeling, anyway.
Monica's not too happy with me right now. I got it, but nothing happened last night that did anything other than prove sort of what I thought this might be, pretty much it's just a bluff, We got a rock through a window with a note and some call through the radio of someone saying, hey, you guys should all leave and come here to this other place instead. I mean, it just sounds like someone's trying to trick us out of our house, And nothing happened last night. They said, they're going to kill you if you aren't gone by sundown. And the whole night went by. And the only thing that happened all night is that neither Monica nor myself got any sleep whatsoever. And Monica used some of the time to make this pretty decent bread. Which was a good use of her time. I don't know. It just doesn't make sense to me to just run scared at every little threat. You don't want your opportunity for retreat to close off if you need to retreat, but I don't see any reason that makes me think that we can't face whatever this is, because I'm just not thinking straight either. But, yeah, I mean, nothing happened last night that made me think that it's anything more than just, you know, some desperate person. And that bugs me, because it's like, if more people had been preppers, if this person had thrown the rock through my window, thank you very much, if that person had been a prepper prior to all this, you know, they wouldn't be desperate now. And, you know, if they've got kids or a family or whatever, you know, you feel bad for that. But, you know, the time to prepare for this, well, not, you know, who sees alien invasions coming, but, you know, you name it, people weren't prepared for it prior to all this. You know, storms, hurricanes, earthquakes, floods, you know, whatever. People weren't prepared for anything. So then people get desperate, and it's like, it's all this foolishness. So, I find it irritating. You know, if this person had just taken some time to prepare a little, they wouldn't be jerking everybody around them. But yeah, at the moment, I don't see any reason to think that it's anything more than just someone jerking us around. Oh, I love fresh bread. Today's day 16, and nothing's happened the past three days since the rock came through. Monica just went down for her sleep shift, and I'm on now. I had an idea, actually, pretty cool idea. Chocolate and peanut butter together at last. Was it like the day after the aliens came in? I was like, I don't have any peanut butter cups, so... it's happening. Mostly it just keep me awake because I'm freaking tired. But, yeah, nothing's happened. So, I'm thinking it was just some person threw a rock through, was hoping they were going to just scare us off. And then when we didn't go anywhere, they just gave up. So... I think it was just a bunch of nothing. Or they would have done better to have taken a rock and thrown it through the window with a note on it that said, please help, I have kids. They're starving them. Maybe I would have given them something, but the way they went about it just didn't accomplish anything. It just made Monica and I kind of pissed and both of us super tired, which is pretty... someone's knocking. Perfect.
Please subscribe and tune in every Friday at 4:30 New York time for a new video. And if you'd like to support this channel, you can do so both through Patreon or PayPal.